everybody, it's Irina Wood and your podcast, Stars About Stars, the first astrology-based matchmaking podcast for love and career seekers. And today we speak about languages of love. Love is a complex and fundamental emotion that can take actually very big quantity of forms. It's often described as a deep affection, attachment, or strong feeling of care and concern for something or somebody. Love can be romantic, platonic, familial, friendly, and even extend to our love for activities, challenges, object, concepts, project. And of course, love demands a lot of passion, intimacy, commitment, and it plays a fundamental role in any type of relationships with your family, friends, and people who are valuable in your life, whom you do appreciate. The language of love usually refers to the concept love languages, which are ways how you do process and deliver your emotions that are connected with this deep feeling that is love. And this theory was popularized by Dr. Gary Chapman in his book, The Five Love Languages. And they are actually, first of all, verbal, so affirmations. Expressing love through verbal affirmation, compliments, and words of appreciation. Sweetie, honey, darling, or any other significant words that could be clear enough in your couple, let's say like this. Maybe it's bunny rabbit, but in this, your husband knows why you call him like that. It's something very nice and memorable for you. Second, it's acts of service. Words of love, they are very beautiful, but it's much more important when you could be present in the moment and you could be helpful in some current important situation for your partner. Nowadays, to say I love you, especially in the United States, everybody's saying I love you, bye. It's nothing. But when you're serious about this phrase, it's actually take a move. It's about to take a move. Action speaks more about real intentions of your partner. Always watch in which way your date is treating people around, family, friends, relatives, employees, or waiters in the restaurants, because some other day on this place, it's going to be you. Since he or she is mean or rude to the others, one day you will take their place, because all these patterns of behavior is actually the same and they are just coming to the mind of this person on repeat. And other things are concrete actions towards you. Providing care, help, being helpful, participating in challenging situations when you're sick, for example, or your car just stuck on the highway, would your partner come and save you and try to help you and release your emotions? Would this person be a part of your problem, saving or helping you, and don't let you feel alone in this trouble? There is always a sense in every single situation. So if with those type of things, they are very challenging, but actually you can check on your partner. Third, it's receiving gift. It's a nice language of love. Me, for example, I love to prepare gifts and surprises, but sometimes it's giving is much more valuable than receiving. Anyway, gifts is a very special energy because it's not only having money and go and buy. First of all, you're making money. And it does mean if you spend that money, it means that you give this energy and you give that talent and you give your skill to that. Second is to choose a gift. It means to spend your time to make a choice and or to ask some other friends of your partner what your loved one would appreciate. So to observe what is important to your significant one. Fourth is quality time. Expressing love by giving someone time because lifetime is the most valuable resource. And let's say we don't know how much left in our pocket. It's not many. And the other thing that you don't realize, how much left. And if you share your lifetime, it's the biggest dedication because you are giving your energy, you're giving your attention, and you're giving this most precious resource. And if you're having together quality time, it's even better because you're creating something in common. It could be hobby or it could be some kind of family tradition or something significant moment of your couple or celebration. Fifth is physical touch. Not everybody is very tactile. There are people who love to hug, who love to kiss their friends and family. The other people, they like to respect their energetic body, to stay a little bit apart. But no matter what, when you're a couple, this sensitivity, this intimacy, it's very important when you kiss, when you feel, when you hug, when you start to be get more and more romantic. Understanding your partner's languages of love, it's very important. Why? Because let's say for your partner, language of love is to be a little bit frozen-hearted, to be very reserved, but from the other side, because it's maybe mentality or nationality or influence of the family created your partner like that. And not every person knows how to show the feelings. For one person is to buy gifts. For the other person is giving a hug. For the third person is just spending money on you. But it's very good when you can mix it up. Or when you question your partner, what is important for you that I can introduce you to my feelings, that you will see that I'm very serious about you? Would you like to spend some time together? Would you like to go for a hike? Would you like to have dinner in the restaurant? Could I cook for you? Or maybe we could create some kind of tradition, a hobby that we're going to experience together. Or would you like to invite our friends that we can feel like family in our round of people? So always ask your partner what's going to be a great manifest of love. And always ask, I have an intention to do this. Would it be valuable for you if my dedication of love is going to be presented to you in this way? So like this, your languages of love can match. They can go together. You can create a variety of those languages of love, and you will understand and appreciate each other better, and definitely create some final great beautiful destination on your own. And it's me, Irina Vislav, and please never forget to subscribe on my YouTube channel Stars About Stars. Always visit my website where you can find out more details about what is going on in Stars About Stars social world, and definitely go and visit my social media.